In this video, I'm going to demonstrate three absolutely brilliant stretches to help you with sciatica pain relief. Now, the three stretches I'm going to demonstrate. The first one is called neuroflossing, so we can floss that sciatic nerve, get a bit more movement in there, and thereby decreasing the pain. The second stretch I'm going to show you is called the advanced neuroflossing, and the last one I'm going to demonstrate to you is called the slump stretch. Okay, let's get started. So the sciatic nerve runs from your lower back into your buttocks, back of your upper leg, back of your lower leg, and then to outside of your foot. And with sciatica, the sciatic nerve is being compressed. In 90% of the cases, that compression happens in the lower back and is due to a slip disc. So the compression is here, and then you're getting symptoms like pain, tingling, weakness, numbness in the buttocks, back of your leg, the calf, or the outside of your foot. So it's not that dissimilar to you hitting your funny bone and you're feeling the tingling in the outer two fingers. It's the same principle. It can be extremely painful as well. Now, before I continue with the stretches, just want to mention to you, I've done two more videos on sciatica as well. Often patients suffering from sciatica struggle to find a comfortable position at night. So I've done a video on that to help you sleep through the night comfortably when you're struggling with sciatica. And I've also done a video to give you a bit more exercises for pain relief from sciatica. So let's get started with the stretches. So this is the first exercise to help you get relief from sciatica pain. This is the easiest exercise. The next one's going to be a bit harder, and if that all goes well, the last one is the hardest one. Now, with all of these exercises, you're allowed, and you probably will get some pain in the back of your leg when you're doing these exercises, but if you're getting a pain in your lower back, you need to do some different exercises first. Just click on the card to go to that video. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to sit upright. Don't slump, make sure you're sitting upright. Place your hands on your legs. And now simultaneously, we're going to tilt our head backwards whilst we're stretching out the affected leg. When we get to the end, we're now going to pull our toes towards up towards our face. We hold this for about 10 seconds. And after 10 seconds, we drop the leg, put the toes down, and then we put our chin on our chest. And the same thing. So we're straightening the affected leg, putting the toes up at the same time, tilt my head backwards, hold this for about 10 seconds, make sure you're upright, don't slump, make sure you're upright, and then we bend the leg, relax the foot, and put a chin on our chest. So you hold each repetition about 5 seconds, repeat this 10 times, and you can do this throughout the day. So if that first exercise goes well, we move on to this exercise. And this is the advanced neural flossing. And what you need to do is place your feet against a wall. Make sure you pull them back as far as you can. So the wall fixates your feet. Make sure your feet don't move down. You want to keep them up. You need to have straight knees. I'm placing my hands behind me, straight elbows. And all I'm doing now is I'm rocking my pelvis. So I'm sitting upright and hold this for about 10 seconds. And after 10 seconds, I'm slouching and hold this for 10 seconds. But make sure you don't bend your knees and don't bend the elbows. Really make sure all the movement comes from your lower back. So this is 10 seconds here. And then after 10 seconds, you slouch again and you hold this again for 10 seconds. And again, this helps to move that nerve through its range, decreasing thereby the sciatica pain relief. Now again, you're allowed to feel pain at the back of your leg, absolutely fine. But if you feel a pain in your lower back, you need to go back to the video that I mentioned before and do some back exercises first. So this final stretch and the most advanced stretch for your sciatic nerve is a slump stretch. So make sure the other two stretches go reasonably well before you do this one. Again, feeling pain in the back of your leg is absolutely fine. If you feel pain in your lower back, you need to do some different exercises first. So the position for this stretch is the same as what we had before with the advanced neuroflossing. So you place your feet against a wall. Make sure that your feet don't down too far. Make sure you pull your feet up. Knees need to be straight. All we're doing now, instead of placing the hands behind us, is interlocking our fingers and placing our hands on our neck. Yeah, so keep your knees straight. First thing we're going to do is we're going to bend, slouch forward. If this goes well, we can then put our chin on our chest. And if that goes well, we can move our body a little bit forward. So we should feel the pain, a stretch in the back of our leg. Hold this for about 10 seconds. And after 10 seconds, we straighten up again. We can place our hands behind us, straighten out the back, and the same thing. So slouching first, chin on the chest. Hold this again for about 10 seconds. And after 10 seconds, straighten up again. And sit upright. So again, repeat this about 5 times. You can do this throughout the day, 2, 3, 4 times a day. Absolutely fine. I hope you found a lot of value in this video. If you did, please don't hold back. Show me appreciation and leave a comment in the section below. Give me a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel. So for now, I'd say take care of yourself. Take care of someone else as well if you can. And bye for now. Bye-bye.